Stormy Daniels has a new book coming out, because you have to read a book by a porn star. I mean, come on. This is a woman who has forged her way using nothing but grit and her genitals toward the head of American public life. This is a woman who was featured on Saturday Night Live telling President Trump to step down because she had consensual sex with him a couple of times. I mean, just amazing stuff from Stormy Daniels. So the new book is called Full Disclosure, and it's now been obtained by the UK Guardian, which is the source of choice for all left-wingers. And basically, the Guardian acts as sort of a conduit for a lot of left-wing material, which is their prerogative. It's a left-wing newspaper. In it, Daniels describes her mounting disbelief as Trump began to win primary contests in 2016 for the Republican presidential nomination. Former castmates, whom she had not heard from in years, but who had heard her story about sleeping with Trump in 2006, would call her up to marvel at the news. As Trump kept winning, Daniels writes, she began to think she might be in danger. And this is where she starts telling her stories again about how she was threatened in 2011 by somebody associated with Trump and all the rest of this, again, providing little to no evidence that this ever happened. She did take a $130,000 payment from Team Trump to shut up about it. And then, of course, she's getting a book deal, so that'll be lucrative for her. She continued to answer Trump's many phone calls over the next year after she had an affair with him back in 2006 in hopes that he would make good on his promise to put her on his reality television show, The Apprentice, Daniel writes. Trump even suggested that a cheat could be arranged to allow her to survive through more episodes of the show. Quote, we'll figure out a way to get you the challenges beforehand, she quotes him as saying, and we can devise your technique. He was going to have me cheat, and it was 100% his idea. Ooh, clearly, he is the nefarious character here. Not you, the porn star who had sex with a married man and then took $130,000 to shut up about it and had sex with him in the hopes that you'd get on TV. Clearly, the only bad character here is Trump. Now, listen, this is not me defending Trump. I think Trump, with regard to women, is dirt. I think he's terrible with regard to the way he's treated women over the course of his life. But Stormy Daniels is not a nun. Okay, Stormy Daniels is not the paragon of female virtue. She's not even the paragon of honesty. Come on. And this is ridiculous. Trump has denied any... I love this. She says, whenever she saw Trump on television, for years afterward, Daniels writes, an internal monologue would play out. I had sex with that, I'd say to myself, eh. Because, but you did, like, this was you. You're not a victim, lady. I mean, you decided you were going to have sex with a married man because you don't care about sex that much and because you thought that it'd be worthwhile to get on The Apprentice. And then there's the part of the book that everybody cares deeply about. This is her first sexual encounter with Donald Trump. Trump's bodyguard invites Daniels to dinner, which turns out to be an invitation to Trump's penthouse, she writes, in a description of alleged events that Daniels has disclosed previously, but which in the book are rendered with new and lurid detail. She describes Trump's genitals, his penis, as, quote, smaller than average, but not freakishly small. I'm so glad we're doing this. Daniels writes, he knows he has an unusual penis. It has a huge mushroom head like a toadstool. All right. And she says, I lay there annoyed that I was getting bleeped by a guy with Yeti pubes and a bleep like a mushroom character in Mario Kart. It may have been the least impressive sex I'd ever had, but clearly he didn't share that opinion. Yeah, so now it's just she's trolling for Trump to respond to all of this. And, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if Trump does respond to all of this. He just has to decide whether he looks more like Yoshi or baby Luigi down there. Like, I don't understand. Legitimately, like, this is where we are. And I look forward to the point when we can be asked about all this on stage. We now have two presidents in my lifetime who've had their penises described in national publications. Right? Paul, we now know what Bill Clinton's penis looked like according to Paula Jones. And we now know what Donald Trump's penis looks like according to Stormy Daniels. And all I can say is that it might be worthwhile for guys to keep it in their pants. How about we start with that life hack? Keep your junk in your pants if you don't want people describing that junk publicly. I do love, though, that Stormy Daniels is playing this as though she was some sort of victim. She went there and she says, you know, Donald promised me that I'd be on The Apprentice. And Trump was probably like, right, The Apprentice, that's what I call my little guy. I want to put you on The Apprentice. it's all so salacious and gross, but this is our politics. This is the game we have chosen. This is the politics we have chosen.